Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to the Lake District. It is really, really atmospheric here. Look at that behind me. Absolutely incredible. Putting down a bit of rain, but that's all right. It's forecast to be blue sky today, so we should be all right. We should get some fantastic views. So I'm going to go up Scafell Pike today, but we're going to go and do Scafell first, and we're going to go via Lord's Rake, which should be a really interesting little route for us. I'm just going to do the rake today. I'm not going to go up on the west wall traverse. I'm going to save that for another day when I've got a lighter pack. So today will be the full rake, and then we'll go up onto Scafell and then carry on the rest of the walk. So yeah, I'm kind of looking forward to this route. I'm looking forward to the day. The weather looks incredible for photography, so we could get some nice pictures and, like I say, some nice footage. So yeah, I'm going to crack on, get to the bottom of the rake, and then carry on from there. Let's go. Right, we're now at the point where you kind of come round the corner and you get your first glimpse of Scafell, or more precisely Black Crag, you can see up there. This is the point where you've got to get your camera out, so that's exactly what I'm going to do, and get some shots. All right, let's try and get across here without falling in. Getting all my camera equipment wet, that would be very, very upsetting indeed. Don't mind my feet getting wet, but not my gear. So nice and gingerly across. I've got no idea if you can hear me. Over to that rock. And then it's a bit loose, that one, but we'll be right. And then that's it, we're done. We're across. That is the first major obstacle on this particular walk up to Lord's Rake. It's not really much of an obstacle, it's just, you know, you've got to be careful because it can be a bit slippy and some of the rocks are wobbly, but, you know, it's all right. Let's take your time. So now it's just that slog up to the bottom of Lord's Rake now, really. And I don't know if you've noticed, but it's starting to get busy. But that does not surprise me whatsoever, because this is the express route up to Scafell Pike. So it's bound to get busy here. So a bit further up, there'll be a point where we fork off to the right. It's pretty much in line with Black Crag, and we'll take that path. The left-hand fork takes you up to Scafell Pike, that zigzag path you see going up. So I'll get me down until that point and then see you there. Let's go. Right, like I said just a minute ago, a bit further up you come to this fork. It's very clearly defined. Probably not in the snow, it wouldn't be that defined, but certainly on a day like today, you can see one going off to the left and one going off to the right, heading towards Scafell. And we're going to take the right-hand one, obviously, and mosey on across to the bottom of Lord's Rake. But look at it now, look at that. So far, so good. It's a beautiful day, just the right temperature, actually. It's not too hot, not too cold. I expect it's going to be very cold on top. I could see a little bit of ice up on on red pike before. It's all clagged in a bit now, but yeah. Okay, I've got to the point where we're going to start heading up to the base of Lord's Rake now. It's this pretty horrible slope of scree. It's not nice at all, but it is a necessity. Got to get up there. I think you can just also see it behind me there. So head up to that, and then we're going to start on the Lord's Rake proper. Now, there's a couple of guys just gone up ahead of me there, so I need to be very careful and let them get ahead and get to the top before I start and get round that corner. Otherwise, a rock could fall down and that's it. It'll be curtains for me. Right, so I'm going to pack my camera away, I'm going to get everything stored away and secured, and then start going up there. I'll try and film as much as I can. It's not going to be easy because it is very, very steep. I mean, we're talking like 45 degree angle, and it's very, very loose underfoot. So there's going to be a lot of slipping, falling and swearing. I'm not too sure if you want to see that, but look at that view. Let me just spin you around. That's Pillar and Red Pike and Scafell, all of them in the cloud. Beautiful. Right, let's do it. Let's go. So it's just a case of getting up here nice and slow and steady. You know, it's no race. You're just taking your time, little steps, picking your route properly, and you'll be fine. Some bits are loose and some bits are all right. So yeah, just take it easy and enjoy it, you know. Right, here I am at the bottom of Lord's Rake. It probably looks nothing in that camera. Just have a look up. Here it is. It probably looks nothing, but my words, it is steep. Like I say, 45, maybe even a bit more than 45. It's it just looks like a wall. It's a long time since I've done this, so in my mind's eye, it wasn't as steep as this. Maybe I just kind of blanked it out, you know. So I'm going to crack on and see how I get on. Right, let's do it. Try and film as much as I can. There are going to be parts, I'm sure, where I'll have to use both hands. Oops. And there'll be times like that where there'll be a lot of slipping. You know, it's not... Well, what I'm going to do as well is go on the right-hand side here. I'm going to cross over and pick that side to go up. I think that's probably the best bet because more handholds on that side. You want to be on a side, really, rather than go up the middle. And then you can duck out of the way if something comes down as well, maybe. But yeah, let's go. Let's get up there. Oops. Sorry if it's a bit wobbly. Doing the best I can. Okay, this is a whole lot of rock that's jammed in place. I hope it's there for a while. Now that's a bit loose. Okay. And right at the beginning, I'm slipping. So let's go up here, up to the left. And onto this big bad boy here. Sorry about the breathing as well, if it's really loud. I'll turn that down if I have to. Yeah, I think this will be much easier with a lighter pack. Whew. here. Like up to there. Oops. And there. Kind of solid-ish. That foot doesn't feel great, I must admit. Let's get up there. There. You can actually see up deep gill there. Look at that, isn't that stunning? Look at all that slimy moss. So that's looking up deep gill and the west wall traverse. Right, there's a guy a bit further behind me, so I'm going to get up and get out of his way so I don't throw any rocks down on his head. Hopefully he'll wait for me, to be clear. Let's just keep pushing on. Yeah. Oops. Don't want to go that way. I don't want to go straight up. I'm going to go straight up here, I think. Just dig in. Dig those boots in. Grab hold of here, I must admit. Oops. God, this bloody bag. He's trying to pull me back. Alright. Making good progress already. Won't be far off where the start of the west wall traverses. And there was that person shouting there. Or a crow. trying to think the best way up this bit. So I think I might have to go across and then up. Let's have a look at this bit here, look. Could just go up there. I'm going to put this away now because I think I need my hands just to get up this bit here and get a bit of balance, and I'll carry on in a minute. Okay, it's making a bit of a fuss over nothing there, actually. You just kind of go around the gravel. And it's actually all right. It's quite deep, thick gravel. You just bomb it up and I think, oop. A bit like that, really. And it's not so bad. But yeah, let's keep pushing on. Hoping this battery doesn't go flat. And hoping this guy doesn't come up behind me because that's dangerous for him. He's waiting, that's all right. That's good. Whew. So actually getting to the point where that fallen chalkstone came to rest a few years back. Almost at that point now. Oh God. A little bit of smooth rock. It's not too bad. And up. And then around here. really sorry if the breathing's too loud. Right. I think I'm just gonna have to go for it here. Yep. Sorry about the grunts as well. Alright. So this is the start of the West Wall Traverse. Let me just show you. So you've got Lord's Rake down there. That guy's boy down there. And then here's the beginning. It's pretty straightforward actually. And to be honest with you, I probably would be all right, but I am really feeling the weight of this bag today, so I can feel it pulling me back. Let that guy go, but he's desperate to get going, you see. And I remember this bit. This bit kind of felt a bit dodgy, but I actually don't think it is. It is literally zigzagging up, finding the good bits of rock. So to there, oh, I must admit that looks horrendous going across there. I think it is the only choice. So, let's have a look. Let's get that foot into there. Yeah, that's not so nice, that bit actually. I think it wasn't so loose, it'd be all right. What to do? I can't remember what I did last time. Oops. Did I climb up that? No, I don't think I climbed up that. Right, I'm going to put this away and work out what the hell I'm going to do. Probably going to go round, I think. Do it that way. So I'll see you in a minute. Okay, that wasn't too bad actually. There were two choices there. I could climb over this boulder here. It's kind of a weird angle, weird sort of feel to it, and quite slippy and also flaky bits of rock, you know, handhold. So I thought I'm not going to do that. I went for the other option, which is like a little chute that runs up the side of the wall there. Let me just go and show you. So this thing here. So I was down there, and you just traverse over and you end up coming up this little mini gully here. Yeah, so it's, I think the hardest part of that was just getting onto that little gully. It's a bit loose, so you really need to take a bit of care there. And then it's quite tight when you're in that gully as well. You just gotta drag yourself up by the handholds that are in there. And it's you know, it's solid rock that, so it's good, it felt nice. So this is the first section done, really. You can see the west wall going off there. Little patches of snow as well, which is quite nice. So first section done. Pretty much filmed all of that then. I don't think you missed any of it, except for that last bit there where I just had to put this away. I had to just kind of throw it ahead of me and climb up using both hands. So there's no way I could have filmed that unless I strapped this to my head, which is something I'm going to be doing. Look at this view. That's a bit special. It is a lot of fun going up there. It's challenging. It's a bit scary. There's no real fear of falling as such. Maybe a little bit of that end bit there, but the fear kind of comes from things falling on you, because like I say, it is very loose underfoot and it's very steep, so something could topple down and clunk you on the head. Really, you should really put a helmet on going up there, just in case. I was a bit naughty for not doing that. So yeah, we just kind of keep on going up. It's much easier now. This is just a very simple path up, which eventually brings us out onto Scafell Crag, and then It's just a short walk up there to the summit. Look at this view. So that's looking back towards the top of the first section now. That's where we came. We kind of came up there. You know, with the right light, that would be a fantastic shot. That Scafell Pike in the background as well, you can see. That's where we'll be later on. Wonderful. God, it's stunning. And just watch my feet around here. You can see the rest of Lord's Rake there. Pretty much done. I mean, it looks like a wall there. Kind of like a vertical wall, but actually when you get to it, it's not so bad. It's not as near as steep as that first section. So what we'll do is we'll just drop down here carefully because it is, again, it is still loose, and carry on, I guess. Carry on to top. Right, just had to rug up a little bit there. Got a bit cold. Stopped to take some photographs of that incredible view. And just before we kind of finish off this final section of Lord's Rake, get a couple of shots off, but I got cold. So it has definitely dropped the temperature now. So, we're sweating here in a minute. It's not a long bit, this actually. It's such a tiny little run. So let's go. Oh, it's getting windy. I thought it would as you kind of reach this chimney effect, I guess. Like a funnel. The wind just whips right through. Right, that's it, almost at the top. A few more steps. Whew. Right, there we go. Not too bad, but certainly gets the blood pumping. And look at that for a view. That's actually looking back towards the old Gill Head and Windrig as well, where I was just a couple of weeks ago actually on the last vlog, last proper hiking vlog. Look at that now. Look at back at the Rake. That is very Tolkien-esque. You can imagine goblins living in those cracks of the rocks there. Awesome. Right, still got quite a bit to do to get top of Scafell, and then from there we're probably gonna, I don't know why I'm saying we again, I'm probably going to bomb it down to Fox's Tarn. I'm not gonna go down Broadstand, that would be suicide. So onward to Scafell and I'll see you a bit further up. Coming on to Simmons Knot here. This is Simmons Knot, and the summit of Scafell is just up here. So let's go and check out the knot. We'll look down onto the West Wall Traverse, and yeah, go and have a view. And what we'll do is we'll go to the summit of Scafell first, go and have a look at that. Then we'll go and have a look at Simmons Knot, and then we'll go down to Fox's Tarn. That's kind of the way we'll be going down. I mean, the summit itself is probably a little bit boring, actually, Scafell, I must admit. It's Simmons Knot that's interesting. looking down into, you know, the West Wall Traverse and Lord's Rake. Summit of Sca Fell. He falls. Just another bald field. Looking back towards Scafell Pike. Okay, that was the summit. Not really much to say about it, really. It's just, you know, it's just a summit with a bit of a cairn on the top, and that's it. Nice view, but really the star of the show of Sca Fell is Simmons Knot. One of the two. Let's go and have a look at that, because that is awesome. Pretty impressive that, isn't it? Looking down into the West Wall Traverse. This is the top section here, obviously. And it's just a little bit of a pull up on wet rock. Like I say, a nice light pack. I'll come and do that, film it. But, oh, it's just an amazing place, isn't it? It really is stunning. Check out this path here. So you can actually see Lord's Rake there down the bottom. You can see the narrow section that I had to climb up and squeeze up. So there is a West Wall Traverse. Let's get to a better vantage point. See the path running along. A little bit of a drop. And then up past some scree. And then up, and it's just really this top section here that kind of worries me a little bit with this bag. How gorgeous is this? It is absolutely incredible up here. You know, Scafell Pike might be the highest, but I think this one is far more interesting. It's got a lot more character. There's no one here. It's absolutely gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. It feels wild and stunning, and there's no one here. And yet, you look across at Scafell Pike, it's like Piccadilly Circus. And I guess that's just because it's higher. People want to go to the highest mountain in England. I get that. But this is far more beautiful. Look at this. Dropping down into Deep Gill. Weather seems to have gone off a little bit. That light seems to have changed over onto on Great Gable there, which is a bit of a shame. I was really hoping it would be a much brighter day today, but still moody, my goodness. Whew. Just not good enough for photographs. Arr. but it might clear out. Although I think the clouds are actually gathering. I'm pretty sure the forecast said that it was going to do the opposite, it'd clear out in the afternoon, but never mind. So we can actually see the route ahead. So we'd have dropped down to Fox's Tarn and then up to Mickledore and across up to Scafell Pike. It's a bit of a slog back up to Mickledore, but it's either that or slide down off Broadstand and die. I don't really fancy doing that. So I think let's crack on, let's get to Fox's Tarn. It's chilly, Willy. Flippin' heck. If you hang around on the summits there, it gets cold. My nose is dripping like mad. I'm so sorry. I don't know if you can hear me. Let me just pop that down a little bit. That's better. Yeah, it does get very cold, as you can see. With a little bit of snow on the top here. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? Both elk crinkles. Oh, it's absolutely gorgeous. Green holes down there somewhere. Camp there overnight. All right, Fox's Tarn. Not much of a tarn, is it? I mean, it's a puddle. It should be Fox's Puddle. That is an interesting, and I completely forgot about this, interesting little bit of a scree run. Not much of a path, more of a slide. You just roll down, but look at the light over there now towards Scafell Pike. Yes, incredible. So we're dropping down a bit more now to pick up the path that's going to take us up over Mickledore. Yes, so far, so very, very good. Just got down the gill from Fox's Tarn. I tell you what, that is challenging. If you had to come down there, be really, really careful, because it's quite slippy. Some quite nasty bits to, not nasty, but just, you know, challenging bits to scramble down in the water, because it's pretty wet at the moment. But now is the bit I've been dreading pretty much all day, and that's the trudge back up to Mickledore, which is the call between Scafell and Scafell Pike. We've got to walk all the way up here, and then we're walking across to the top of Scafell Pike. But outstanding views down to Esdale. Absolutely gorgeous. Before you start this bit, go up to Mickledore, make sure you have yourself a Snickers or whatever treat it is that you like. It give you some energy, because you're going to need it. Right, I'm going to push on and get up to Mickledore and have a break, I think. So, see you in a sec. Just getting to the stretcher box now on Mickledore. That is a slog up there, you know. My God. Especially when your legs are a little bit tired anyway from going up Lord's Rake and then coming down that gill from Fox's Tarn. But look at this for a view. We'll get a little bit higher and then we'll have a look back. But it is something else. It's actually quite good there's some people there. Gives it a bit of scale. What I'll do is I'll just pop up onto here onto this edge, and we'll go and have a look, and we should be able to see Lord's Rake from here, where I was earlier. So you can see Lord's Rake. Look at Broad Stand, my God. Okay, let's bomb it up to the top of Scafell Pike, get this done, and then I think we have something to eat. I've not had breakfast yet. It's like 2 o'clock. I don't know if you can see that. Incredible. Lots of people coming off the top now. Oh, going home. But I was just going to say, there's a lot more snow and ice around over on this side than there was over on Scafell. I'm a little bit on the clock today, really. I think if I wasn't on the clock against the light, I would probably have a bit more of a rummage around Scafell Pike Summit. Go and have a look at Pulpit Rock, for example. Seriously, how often do you see Scafell Pike without anybody on it? Very rare. There's no one here. There's a lot more snow on this side. I wouldn't say it was deep, but it's definitely noticeable underfoot. It's slippy. A few more people turning up. Get inside here. Oh, that's better. Whew. Nice little fireplace. Nice view. Around, and it's sheltered. Welcome to Lingmell Coll, which is, as the name suggests, coll between Lingmell and Scafell Pike. There. Some incredible light in Wasdale. I mean, look at it. I'm in the wrong spot here, though. I can't quite see down. I need to be on Lingmell itself. Same happened a minute ago when I was on Scafell Pike. Great Gables just looking. Ooh, unbelievable. But I had Scafell Pike in the way, the mountainside is in the way, so I couldn't photograph it. I'm sorry, I'm just mourning like mad. I might get a view in a minute. But that's, I must admit, that's looking quite staggering actually, towards Stair Tarn and beyond. So the bit that's got sunshine on it, I don't know if you can see it in this camera, but that's the bit coming off Glaramara. Very nice. It's about an hour before sunset now. Oops. And you know, this time of day, it just gets really quiet. I'm going to find this path that's going to take me up to Lingmell and stop jibber-jabbering and get up there. Okay, just getting to the top of Lingmell. Not that you'd ever know, because it's just clagged in. Can you believe it? I was watching the clouds rolling in over Ilgill Head, and it looked pretty stunning, but now they've rolled right across the top of us. Us. So I'm really hoping for a bit of a miracle here, actually. Hope that the cloud just lifts a little bit so I can get a bit of a view and see the sunset. Because that'd be nice, wouldn't it? You know, I'm here. So I can see Stired Tarn, that's a bonus. Nothing else, though. What a shame, because I know that view is just... Although, a little bit of it is clear. Let's go on. Get a bit closer to the edge. Not too close. Ooh, yes. That's lovely. That is a beautiful view. Do you see why this is one of my favourite mountains? That's Piers Gill down there. That is our answer to the Grand Canyon. I absolutely love that place and this mountain and that view. Got the cloud just dropping down into there. Oh, I love it. I really do love it. Right, what I'm going to do then is I'm going to have a little bit of a sit down and a break, and then there's no sunrise, so I might as well start bombing it down to Wasdale. I think it's probably going to be dark by the time I get there, but I'll film as much as I can and then wrap it up at some point. I don't know when. It might be very dark, but in the meantime, I'm going to enjoy that. See you in a bit.
Hey, Herdy.
Well, the sun's down. It's now time for some brekkie. I've literally had no time at all today. I've just not stopped. It's been so busy, so I think I deserve a bit of food, especially right now because this is the really steep bit of Lingmell that takes you back down to Wasdale, and it is steep, so I just need to switch on and have some energy. But lights of the pub are on. It's darker than it looks on this screen, I can tell you that now. I reckon I've probably got about 15 minutes of light left, hence the torch. But it's pretty much all grass all the way down now, so I just need to be careful I don't slip and, you know, slide back to the car. But yeah, I'll eat this, get some sustenance, and then so I thought there's someone over there. I'll see you at the car. Yeah, like I said before, but I need to eat, so I'll see you at the car. What a day. It's been fantastic, epic day out in the lakes. I set off this morning from the car about 7:30 and I got back about 5:30 in the dark. As you can see, it is pitch black now, which is, you know, a lot of fun when you're walking in the dark off the hill. As long as you've got a decent head torch, it's really nice. It's very serene, it's very peaceful, there are no crowds. It's, yeah, it's all right. So yeah, what a day. It's been such a long day. So much has happened. You know, Lord's Rake seems like 3 weeks ago. But anyway, I really hope you enjoy the route. I hope you do get a chance to do it. Don't be put off by some of the bits and pieces like the Lord's Rake or the or Fox's Tarn, you know, going down from there. It's definitely worth doing. And as always, I'll put the route in the description. so you can follow along. Right, so I'm going to get myself home and have a couple of beers. I'm absolutely hanging out for a beer now. So, yeah, as usual, if you've liked it, give us a thumbs up and please subscribe and please comment as well. And I'll see you on the next one. Cheers. Because it really is like a landscape from, you know, from another time, prehistoric time. Am I talking garbage? I am, Anna. Ooh, God. I'm not doing the splits.